Where do you call home? We're not talking about your street address. We don't even mean your country. Mother Nature has a different kind of home address for you. It rhymes with home. Biome. Your biome isn't associated with a specific country or even just one place on the globe. It's more like if you add up all the natural characteristics of where you live and give that a name. Think of the Earth as a place where every corner of the planet has its own unique personality and inhabitants. These diverse landscapes, called biomes, are like nature's neighborhoods. From icy tundras where polar bears roam to steamy rainforests buzzing with colorful birds and insects, each biome supports a different community of plants and animals. Exploring biomes helps us understand how living things survive in their environments and thrive in places as different as deserts, grasslands, and even the depths of the ocean. Today, we'll learn about some of the different biomes and how diversity makes our planet so special. We've gathered some naturally wonderful things for you to explore on the Socratica Foundation website. Find more smart, fun videos and downloads, fact-filled games and activities that help you learn and remember. Find the link below. Where do we get this word? Biome. Does it mean two of something? Like how a bicycle has two wheels? No. Let's split it up like this instead. Bio plus ome. The word biome comes from two Greek words, bios, which means life, and ome, which means group. When you put these roots together, biome refers to a group of similar living things. So, a biome is a place on Earth where the plants and animals all have a lot in common. What's more, biomes also have the same sorts of weather conditions. For instance, a desert biome typically has hot temperatures and very little rain. So, it makes sense that deserts have plants and animals that can survive in the heat with very little water. This helps us understand that a biome is not just about one thing, like temperature, but a combination of living and non-living things that create a unique environment. Also, you know, there isn't just one desert in the world, right? When we say desert, it means anywhere on Earth that has the same sort of dry conditions and similar sorts of plants and animals that can survive there. Each biome has unique weather patterns, like how much rain or snow it gets, and unique temperature ranges. The weather influences the types of plants that can grow there, which then impacts the animals that can live there. Deserts are dry and hot, so they have cacti and animals like lizards and snakes that can survive without a lot of water. On the other hand, rainforests are warm and wet. This means living things like tall trees, monkeys, and parrots can thrive here. Other biomes include grasslands, tundras, and oceans. Understanding biomes helps scientists learn how different parts of our planet function and how living things interact with their environments. Since we're going to use a serious scientific term like biome, let's add in the words that scientists use to describe them. By the way, the scientists using these terms, studying biomes, they're called ecologists. We mentioned certain plants and animals that live in biomes. Ecologists call the plant life of a biome flora. That might remind you of a flower, which is good because flowers are an example of flora, the plant life found in a certain region. There's a word that goes along with flora, but it's for the animals, fauna. Fauna makes us think of fawns, which is the name for a baby deer, and little baby deer are an example of fauna, the animals that live in a certain place. One more word we should know, climate. You'll hear people using the words weather and climate interchangeably, but there is a difference. Climate is the word we use when we want to talk about the average weather of a place over a long period of time. And that makes sense that a desert might occasionally get a rainstorm. There's no law against it, and that's weather. But on average, over a long period of time, it barely rains at all. And that's climate. Ecologists are known for studying ecosystems, but they also study biomes? What gives? You might be thinking that a biome sounds a whole lot like an ecosystem. You're on the right track. They are similar, but they have some differences too. A biome is a large area of the earth with similar climate, flora, and fauna, like a desert, forest, or ocean. It covers a wide region and includes many different ecosystems within it. An ecosystem, on the other hand, is a smaller, specific community of living things interacting with each other and their environment in a specific place. For example, a forest biome includes many ecosystems, such as a pond, a meadow, or a grove of trees. Long story short, a biome gives us a big picture of similar environments across the world, while an ecosystem focuses on the details within a smaller area. Socratica Kids is an educational nonprofit, and our videos are possible because of people like you. Donate today and help us get started on our next video series all about the animals who live in these special biomes. Now that we know what a biome is, we can get into the nitty-gritty and jump right into a controversy. How many biomes are there? Scientists group biomes in different ways. Some scientists say there are five main biomes: aquatic, desert, forest, grassland, and tundra. Others say there are 11 biomes, which include Arctic tundra, Alpine tundra, Antarctic tundra, boreal forest, temperate forest, tropical grassland, temperate grassland, desert, marine, and freshwater. Phew, that was a long list. Here at Socratica Kids, we'll be exploring each of these 11 biomes in more depth with one video for each biome. Be sure to subscribe so you don't miss a video. For simplicity's sake, today let's take a quick look at the five major biomes as an introduction. But don't forget, lots of upcoming videos. Please subscribe. Okay, here we go. First up, aquatic biomes. Aqua means water, like aquarium. So you know aquatic biomes are all about water and include oceans, lakes, rivers, and ponds. These watery worlds are home to a variety of creatures, like fish, whales, frogs, and turtles. Plants like algae and seaweed thrive here too. Aquatic biomes can be freshwater, like lakes and rivers, or saltwater, like oceans and seas. The animals and plants in these biomes are well suited for living in the water, some in the deep ocean trenches and others in shallow riverbeds. Animals living in aquatic biomes can only survive here and would not do well in the rest of the biomes, which we call terrestrial biomes. Terra means earth, and that might make you think first about a place where it's mostly dirt. That's right, we're talking about the desert. Dirt, sand, rocks. But don't be fooled, deserts aren't completely empty. Just mostly empty when you compare them with other places on Earth. Desert biomes are dry areas with very little rain. They can be hot, like the Sahara, or cold, like the Gobi. So what sorts of flora and fauna call deserts home? Plants like cacti and shrubs are tough and can store water for a long time. Animals such as camels, lizards, and scorpions are perfectly suited to survive in these harsh places, often being active at night to avoid the heat. Deserts might look desolate at first glance, but they're full of life that has learned to make the most of the scarce water and food available. You know which biome does not look empty? Forest biomes. Forest biomes are full of trees and all kinds of critters that live in and around them. These biomes come in three main types: tropical, temperate, and boreal. Tropical forests are warm and rainy with tall trees and a huge variety of plants and animals, like delicious tropical fruits and animals that like to eat fruit, including monkeys, parrots, and butterflies. Temperate forests have four seasons, with trees that change color in the fall and lose their leaves in the winter. Animals like deer, bears, and owls live here. Boreal forests, also known as taiga, are found in cold regions and have evergreen trees like pine and spruce. Animals such as moose and wolves roam these forests. As you can see, forests are teeming with life. Remember, we'll learn more about each one of these forest biomes in their own video. What about the places where there are fewer trees, more open and grassy? We call those grassland biomes. These biomes are wide open spaces dominated by grasses and very few trees. They can be temperate, like the prairies in North America, or tropical, like the savannas in Africa. Grasslands are home to large herbivores like bison, zebras, and elephants, as well as predators like lions and wolves. These biomes have rich soil that is great for growing crops, making them important for farming. Another vast and open biome is the tundra, but don't expect to see big trees or tall grasses in these places. Tundra biomes are very cold and have little plant life. They can be found in the Arctic, near the North Pole, and high on the mountains. The ground is often frozen, so only very small, hardy plants like mosses and lichens can grow. Animals like reindeer, Arctic foxes, and polar bears live in the tundra. These animals have special adaptations to survive in the extreme cold, like thick fur and protective fat layers. The tundra is a tough place to live, but it has its own unique beauty and important role supporting life on Earth. We just finished a whirlwind tour through the Earth's unique neighborhoods, biomes, each with its own climate, plants, and animals, and you're back home in your own biome. From the deep blue oceans to the dry deserts, the lush forests to the wide grasslands, and even the icy tundras, each biome is a vital part of our planet's rich diversity. This knowledge helps us appreciate the incredible variety of life on Earth and the importance of protecting these natural habitats. Don't forget to watch the rest of our biome series where we take a deep dive into each biome and the diversity within them. Now it's time to watch another great video from Socratica Kids. You get to pick. And don't forget to check out our website with smart fun extras we made just for you, linked below. Did you know that these videos are made possible by our donors? The Socratica Foundation is committed to making free educational resources for kids. Donate today.